Today in this lecture, we are going to discuss the buffer function of baroreceptor, because the baroreceptors oppose change in the arterial pressure. It increases the pressure when it is decreasing and it decreases the pressure when it is decreasing. That's why it is known as a pressure buffer system, and the nerves involved in the baroreceptor buffer system are known as the buffer nerves. Previously, we have discussed that baroreceptors are basically present in aortic arch and carotid bifurcation in the carotid sinus, and they basically detect stretch in the blood vessel. When the pressure increases in the blood vessels, these receptors are stretched. Due to the stretch, the signals go to the brain, and then this brain basically sends signals back and takes action accordingly. If the arterial pressure has increased, the brain tries to bring the pressure down, and if the pressure has gone down, then the brain tries to improve the pressure through different mechanisms. The mechanisms with which the way with which the baroreceptor function, or the brain and the baroreceptor increase or decrease the arterial pressure, have been discussed in detail in the previous few lectures. Now in this lecture, we are going to demonstrate with few experiments the buffer function of the baroreceptor. Or a buffer is anything which resists change. That's why the nerve, the glossopharyngeal nerve and the vagus nerve, that are basically taking part in taking the signals to the brain and from the brain to the blood vessels and the heart, they are known as buffer nerves. We are basically discussing the nervous regulation of the circulation, that how the nervous system is involved in regulation of the circulation. And then we are, as a category, we are discussing the baroreceptor arterial pressure control system. We have discussed the physiologic anatomy of the baroreceptor arterial pressure control system. And then we have discussed the mechanism with which the baroreceptor sends the signal and how the brain then act on those signals. Now, here we are having an example of dogs. This is arterial pressure graph of a normal dog. And here we have a graph taken from the same dog when the dog has been denervated. Now this is the graph of normal dog, and this dog has been denervated. Baroreceptors are of course present in dogs, so the result, the experiments have been done on dogs, and the baroreceptors, when removed from the dogs, they are then known as denervated dogs in this specific experiment. Now in this experiment, you can see when the baroreceptors are present in a normal dog and the dog is doing his normal daily activities, the main arterial pressure of the dog is strictly maintained around 80 to 120, or mostly it is maintained around 100 mm of mercury. This graph is showing pressure. It is showing increasing pressure and decreasing pressure. But vertically, we have on the y-axis, we are showing the pressure. And this is basically time. This is a 24 hours duration. So in the 24 hours, the pressure, the arterial pressure in the blood vessels of the dog has increased and decreased. But as the baroreceptors of this dog are intact, it is the normal baroreceptors are present. So the mean arterial pressure is maintained strictly around 100 mm of mercury. Now this dog is denervated, the baroreceptors are removed from the aortic arch and the bifurcation of the carotids. Now you can see that the mean arterial pressure is deviating quite frequently from the mean from the 100 mm of mercury. Here it was basically being maintained around 80 to 120 mm of mercury. Here it can come to around 50 mm of mercury, and it can go to around 180 mm of mercury. The same dog with normal baroreceptors and then when denervated, there is a lot of difference, a difference of around one third of variations could be reduced in the mean arterial pressure or the arterial pressure if the baroreceptors are intact in a normal mammal or a normal human being, the variation of the arterial pressure can be minimized around one third if the baroreceptors are functional. So in this experiment, it is proved that if the baroreceptors are normally functioning, the arterial pressure is maintained strictly. When the baroreceptors are removed, then the arterial pressure starts showing variations. And the variations are quite frequent throughout the day. So this is a record of, again, 24 hours duration. Now, the results have been shown on this graph as well. Now, this graph basically showing frequency distribution. Because the frequency of normal pressure and the frequency of abnormal pressure has been distributed. Now, here we have the percentage of occurrences of abnormal pressure, and here we have the mean arterial pressure. If the dog is normal with normal baroreceptors, the percentage of the time, the percentage of occurrences of abnormal pressure, the percentage of occurrence of normal pressure, the percentage of occurrence of normal pressure is more. And you can see that most of the time the pressure of this dog, the mean arterial pressure of this dog, has been maintained around 80 to 120. And most of the time it has been around 100. It has been around 100, like the percentage of being normal is very much high up to this level. But when the same dog is denervated, then the percentage of being normal decreases and the variation has increased. The variation or the frequency has distributed a long way, or the variation has increased. So the arterial pressure has fallen around 50 mm of mercury or 40 mm of mercury, and then the arterial pressure has also increased to around 160 and 170 mm of mercury. So x-axis is showing the mean arterial pressure, and the y-axis is showing the percentage of occurrence of the normal and abnormal pressure. If the baroreceptors of the dog are intact, normal, then the frequency of being normal is very much high, and the frequency of abnormality at the lower side and at the higher side is very much low, or the BP or the arterial pressure has been strictly maintained around 80 to 120, and most of the time it has been around 100 mm of mercury. But when the same dog is denervated or the baroreceptors have been removed from this dog, then the arterial pressure start distributing more and more towards the lower side and towards the higher side, and the frequency has distributed and the variations have increased. So here you can clearly see that this graph has broadened. The base of this red color graph is very much broad, because the frequency has distributed so much. It has come to around 50 mm of mercury. The BP has also increased to around 160-170 mm of mercury, and the percentage of occurrence of being normal has been low. Here it has been very much high, like the percentage of occurrences of mean arterial pressure being normal has decreased, like on a very few occasion or very small amount of time, the arterial pressure has been normal, or at a very, and the percentage of arterial pressure being normal is very low, and in the normal blue color graph the percentage of being normal is very, very high. So this is basically showing the percentage of the arterial pressure being normal, and it's very high in the normal dog, and in the denervated dog it's distributed, so it's very much low. So these two experiments basically prove that the baroreceptors basically try to keep the arterial pressure within a narrow normal range. And once the baroreceptors have been removed, the variation starts in the mean arterial pressure, and there are the frequency of distribution, like the base of the frequency of distribution broadens. Here you can clearly see that the base of this frequency distribution has broadened because the dog has been denervated, or the buffer system which decreases the variation has been removed. So that's all about the buffer function of the baroreceptor. Hope you have understood. I have tried my best to explain that the role of the baroreceptor is to maintain the mean arterial pressure. And basically the baroreceptors are connected with the nervous system, the brain and spinal cords. So this is something which proves that the nervous system is basically important in regulation of the circulation. Thanks a lot for watching the video.